I'm Raaghav from class 7M of ASL. I would like to present you a TED talk on the topic, Let's Get Addicted to School. We all agree that students and children are more knowledgeable than teachers of this topic. Yes, I'm talking about games. On this data, you can clearly see that the games are not restricted to gaming consoles. As you see on this data, 51% of the global market share of games is on phones and tablets. And I'm sure we all have access to one or multiple of these devices. With the availability of games, specifically hyper-casual ones, it's not surprising that we have played these games on our devices. Talking about hyper-casual games, here's an example, Tetris. Tetris has a download figure of about 170 million. This is a staggering number. People play this game at first to kill time, but then get hooked to these games and keep playing it even when they really don't have time to kill. Minecraft is a strategy game. It also has a huge fan following with a download figure of 140 million. It's not a casual game. It involves strategy and decision making. And I'm sure it's very interesting. It can keep you engaged for hours together. GTA is a war and combat game. Who does not like to shoot and destroy the enemies? It has 100 million downloads. With these staggering numbers and the clever manipulation by game developers to pull in more and more users, are we getting addicted to these games? Are we in control of ourselves in how we spend our free time? Or should I say, even our productive time? We may differ in our thought processes here. Some may say that this is not a major issue, but some may see a big red flag here. Now let's talk about the professional and positive side of this whole game world. If you see on this image, you can see a stadium full of gaming enthusiasts watching their favorite player play and cheering for their team. When I first told my parents about this tournament and its magnitude, at the level of participation by game lovers, they were astonished. It's just not this game, but as a profession and as a career, it is as equal to as any other game such as cricket, tennis or chess. Sahil Arora, also popularly known as Universe, is one of the highest earning gamers in the world. And I'm sure his parents will be proud of him playing games. Gaming as a profession is a huge topic, and I think we will need a separate TED talk to cover it. Whether positive or negative, these games are addictive and we get hooked to it very soon. And these can be dangerous too. How dangerous? We all have seen that the Blue Whale Challenge. It was so addictive that the people got hooked to it and committed suicide to complete the challenge. So what is addiction? Brain registers all pleasures in the same way. Let it be by your playing a game, or the happiness when you get a monetary reward. You have felt that urge to reach out to your phones when you get that notification bell from your favorite social media apps. A little more relatable, the urge to eat that last slice of pizza when you know that you already have overeaten. Addiction is nothing but the hijacker of the reward center of the brain. And these game developers have mastered the skill of manipulating and hijacking the reward center of the brain. And taking the clue from these game developers and the positive benefits from it, educational content developers have started gamifying the process of learning. A few examples of the gamification in learning is of Byju's, Khan Academy, and our very own 10 educational initiatives. If you have not explored these as of now, I highly recommend you do. These apps and platforms are engaging and intuitive. The learning is based on rewarding and appreciating an effort and hitting the right reward center of the brain. With these animated apps and learning programs over the internet, have the school started getting boring and boring day by day? Is coming to school as entertaining as playing a game? This is an important question to answer, because it is easy to blame the traditional education methods or the school. But if you see, even in the traditional education methodologies, gamification is deeply involved. We just need to open our eyes and start to relate. You'll be pleasantly surprised when you see the similarities. Let me take you through this. When you complete a level in a simple level in a game, you usually get stars. If you remember, in nursery or kindergarten, you usually used to get stars and smileys on your hand. A plus or a smiley from a favorite teacher is bigger than any other reward. It encourages you to do even better next time. The game is made more interesting by playing in a squad and achieving your target. In schools also, we have group projects in which we have a lot of fun, such as Math Amity or Vasudha. These in which we design and do our projects with a lot of pride. As the science and technology is increasing, virtual reality games have also come and the schools are also adapting. Virtual reality games are very popular nowadays and the schools also have smart boards and digital technologies to make the learning more fun. As there are different game boards, it's games such as practice board, arcade board or tournament board. In schools, you have different tests and exams. Usually in the game, the last board is tournament board and in schools, it is the final exams in which we do our best in the finals as we do in games. There are different levels can be compared to different grades in schools. Currently, I am in the 7th level of this fun game called school and I am looking forward to do my best and move on to the 8th level. We will all agree that in teaching us and imparting us with knowledge, teachers and elders are more knowledgeable than us. As students and young adults, we should learn the maximum from them. We should have the right mindset towards school and education and make the experience more fun and not as a burden. Let's get addicted to school. Thank you.